Cracked Ball.
Bubsy, thank you so much for being with us. Normally, you are the one interviewing me. Is this a little strange that I'm asking you the questions?
I find it very strange because I think I've interviewed you about, I don't know, 20 times before, and today it's your turn to ask me anything.
Exactly, and I'm going to start with you as a tennis player. Maybe you do remember when you used to be a tennis player that you were interviewed, and you had a really good run here in Hamburg, 2-time semifinals, 2 titles in doubles with Martina Hingis. Do you remember any of that?
I do remember that I have been on the tour a very long time ago, but no, I do remember playing with Martina here and Patty, with Martina especially, because I felt like I just had to serve and return and everything else Martina did. So I was kind of a statist out there on the court, not doing much, and I loved it. I was like, oh, we should team up a little bit more often, because it was really, really fun to play with her. And then in singles, I remember once I lost against Mary Pierce in the semis, and the other one I have no recollection about that, but I do remember that I loved playing here. It was always at the time where it was kind of cold, it was raining a lot, and the deeper the clay was, the more I felt like, you know, I felt comfortable on
yeah
it.
So you like to grind in
the grinding, yeah.
But do you remember, was it the year when Mary Pierce won the French Open then in the end, or you don't remember that?
I don't think it was that year. I think I played against Eva Maioli here when she won the French right after. Yeah,
okay.
But I can't remember if I lost her, if I beat her.
Did you, I was asking myself this because I'm also doing a little bit of broadcasting, and I was asking myself, did you take anything from being a tennis player with you into the broadcasting world, like mentally or even like something else? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, totally. First of all, I think the adrenaline you used to have on the court, that's what I get now doing live TV, especially with the shows, you know, when you hear the countdown in your ear and it's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then you're just connected with the producer. And it's always kind of nerve-wracking, you know, and I love that. That's as close as you can get to, I think, playing on a center court with thousands and thousands of people. But also in certain moments, you know, when it gets a little bit stressful, you know, technically there's something wrong, or you get disconnected with your producer, you don't really know what to do in the show, you stay calm and you deal with stress differently,
right.
I think. And I've only realized that recently, that that's coming from my tennis career, you know, where you have to, I mean, you know it, you know, you're always kind of under pressure, you expect a lot from yourself, but you stay, kind of have to stay calm. And I think that's the two main things I've gotten out of my tennis career.
That's at least the ideal version, that you stay calm when the pressure comes crashing down.
Well, on the tennis court, I didn't really stay calm, but in front of TV, because it's not just you, you're responsible for the whole, you know, for Eurosport or for the whole broadcaster, and millions of people are watching you, so you kind of have to stay calm. You can't freak out.
Is there anything that you hate as a broadcaster, for not on players, but like that broadcasters do that maybe haven't played tennis? Is there anything that is an absolute no-go for you, where you're like, no, I'm going to protect the players in that regard?
Yeah, there's always situations where I still feel like I'm a little bit of a player, you know, like doing too many interviews, too long of interviews, or asking inappropriate questions. I always know where to draw the line, you know, that it doesn't, it kind of gets personal, but not too personal,
right,
you know?
Interesting, yeah.
So it's kind of a, you know, a pact between the players, I think, and it doesn't matter, you know, if you played 20 or 30 years ago or now, it is a family at the end of the day, and you have to respect that. And certain times when they say, oh, you should ask this or that, maybe I say, no, I won't go this direction.
That's good. So we have a protector in you.
Yes.
I have just one last question. It might be a little weird, but I was just checking your Wikipedia page just for fun, and I saw that you had a tremendous career. You had a career high of number 7. You played multiple Grand Slams really far. You were great in doubles, and your total prize money was $3.7 million, which obviously compared to today is not comparable at all. And I'm wondering if you feel a little, if you feel proud that tennis has come so far, or women's tennis has come so far, or if you're also a little sad that you haven't played maybe 10 years later.
Well, you know, it's a combination, I think. I'm very proud how far women's tennis has come, especially with the equality at the Grand Slam tournaments. When I used to play, it wasn't equal.
It was
prize
not like
money.
That, yeah.
And yeah, you're right, prize money went up like three times more, I think, after I played. But, you know, I'm happy with the generation I've played with. I had a great time. Obviously, I'm still standing here, so I have to work, you know. But tennis is my passion, and it's not all about the money. It gives you security, but it certainly doesn't give you complete happiness. So I'm happy to be around still on the tour, and hopefully, you know, women's tennis can progress even more so in the future.
That's awesome. And just one last thing. It's more a tip from you to me. How does your body feel today after playing so much tennis in the past? Like, what do I have to prepare myself for going into 8 years looking from that?
I felt fine. I was never really injured while I was playing. But it kind of started once I turned 40. I was like, I feel my knee a little bit. I feel my back a little bit. So you start to get rusty. I think you're fine for a few years when you still have the muscles. Mm-hmm. And I do work out all the time. But yeah, you have little aches and pains, but knock on wood that it's not going to get worse. I still can do pretty much everything. But I think, you know, you'll find out yourself. Hopefully it's not going to be too bad.
Well, thank you very much. And
well done.
Yes, yeah, you are. Trying my best. See you soon.
Hamburg European Open.